What is going on, Yankee fans? It is New York Sports Hub here, and I am back at it with another New York Yankees post-game recap. And in this video, we're going to recap tonight's game between the Yankees and the Red Sox. We'll talk about, we'll briefly talk about yesterday's game between the Yankees and the Royals. You know, we'll just talk about the Yankees, how they've played the past two games, talk about Domingo Herman's start tonight, we'll talk about the offense, we'll talk about Gary Sanchez's hot streak, we'll talk about Aaron Judge, Stanton, all those guys. You know, just the team in general in this video. So if you're a Yankees fan, drop a like on the video and subscribe to the channel. I really would appreciate it. Hit that notification bell so you do not miss any of my videos. And also, if you're a Giants or Knicks fan, hit that subscribe button as well because I upload videos on those two teams as well. So let's get right into this video. So the Yankees played the Red Sox tonight, and they lost 5-3, but they did win the series against the Royals. They won yesterday's day game 8-1 at Yankee Stadium, and Jameson Taillon got the start in this one, and I don't know his exact line, but I know he went his longest outing of the year. He went, I think, 6 1/3, gave up one run, only like 4 or 5 hits, didn't walk a lot of guys, and, you know, he struck out a decent amount of hitters. I thought Jameson Taillon did a really, really good job pitching yesterday. I thought he did a really, really good job on the mound. Ended up shutting down the Royals, made that one mistake to Sebastian Rivero, giving up that double, which Clint Frazier should have fielded a lot better. Probably should have been 2nd and 3rd, no one out. And but, you know, Clint Frazier's just not good defensively at all. He can't even hit either. But he's also just not a good defensive outfielder at all, and he kind of bobbled the ball. And that caused Nicky Lopez to score. That made it a 4-1 game. And then he had 1st and 2nd, no one out. It looked like he was going to unfold. But then he got Merrifield to... He walked Merrifield. He got Santana to line out and then got Perez to ground into the double play. I think he lined it to a double play to end the inning. I think Santana might have flied out. And that is how the inning ended there. So a good job by Taillon to get out of the jam. And then he gives you a 0 in the 6th inning. Then gets an out in the 7th. And then ends up leaving the game. But I thought Jameson Taillon did a really, really good job against the Royals yesterday. I thought he did a really good job. And got the win in the game. I think got his, 2nd or 3rd win of the year, and the Yankees won the game 8-1. Great home run by Sanchez. I mean, that ball was a bomb into the bullpen. Great job by Sanchez to break it open there in that 6th inning. Giancarlo had a really good game. He had, I think, 2 or 3 hits. Aaron Judge had a home run, and he had 3 hits as well. He got on base 5 times in that game. Aaron Judge was, he had a great game against the Royals in that game. He was fantastic. 3 hits and got on base 5 times. He hit the home runs. That was a great game for Judge. Luke Voit hit a home run in that game as well. His 2nd of the season. Well, not his 2nd since coming off the IL. I think it might have been his 3rd of the year. His 2nd since coming off the IL. That made it a 4-0 game. And the Yankees found a way to get to Brad Keller early on in the game. We had Odor getting an RBI in the 1st inning, which was huge. But the Yankees offense did a really good job against the Royals in that series finale. Got the series win. And the Yankees improved to 40-34. Obviously, before tonight, they're 40-35 now. But they were 40-34 after the win against the Royals yesterday. So, let's talk about tonight's game. And this game was a very, very frustrating game on both sides of the ball. Because Domingo Herman got the start. Had one really bad inning. He had that 1st inning where he completely fell apart. Gave up the 2-run double to Xander Bogaerts just because he's really good at baseball. And also gave up the double to Hunter Renfroe. It was 3-0 Boston after 1. And it's very, very hard to win ballgames when you're coming, when you're always trailing early on in the game. It's very, very hard to win games that way. And that's just what Domingo Herman gives you on a daily basis. I mean, he started off the year, he was great. His past, 4 or 5 outings, he's been atrocious. He's been terrible. Domingo Herman's good start seems like a fluke. I mean, when he faces a good offense, he really struggles, and he didn't, you know, in this game. He went 4 innings, 4 runs. That's just not going to cut it. He did not pitch well whatsoever, and he did not give us enough length for the Yankees to win this game. Did not think he pitched well at all. Now, he did kind of settle down after the 1st inning, but still gave up a lot of hits, walked a few guys. He did not pitch well. He didn't pitch well whatsoever. I was very disappointed with his performance, especially that 1st inning. Domingo Herman was not very good on the mound at all. And as for the bullpen was fine. I didn't have any problems with the bullpen. Litke did a good job. Who else? Loaisiga did a good job. Zach Britton ended up leaving the game with an injury. I think he'll be all right, but he left the game with a... It looked like it was like a groin injury or whatever. I don't know what it was, but he left the game with an injury. Let's hope Zach Britton's okay. Let's hope it's not an IL stint for him. But he left the game with an injury. And Sessa gave up a run in the 8th inning, but they were going to lose anyway, so it didn't really matter. But I thought the bullpen was fine. I didn't have any problems with the bullpen, but I just thought Domingo Herman pitched really poorly. And the Yankees offense just did not get the job done, getting 3 runs on 9 hits. They left a lot of men on base, as usual. Gleyber Torres had another horrible game. Gary Sanchez kind of struggled. Judge didn't have a great game. DJ was terrible. once again. Had that RBI single, but outside of that, he was terrible. Giancarlo played okay. Voit had two hits, which was great to see. And Duhar had three hits. Great game for Miggy tonight. He had a really good game. He had that hit in the ninth inning, which didn't amount to anything. But he had three hits tonight. Great game for Miguel Andujar. He had a really, really good game. Gio kind of struggled in this game. He did have a double in this game. I forgot about that. And then he was sent home for some reason, which I'll talk about later in the video because Phil Nevin's just an idiot. But, yeah. I mean, the offense just didn't get the job done tonight. That's the bottom line. The offense did not get the job done. Three runs is not going to be able to beat a really good Boston Red Sox team. It's just not. It's not good enough. And this offense is it's unbelievably streaky. One game they look great. Next game they look awful. I don't care what pitcher you're facing. You should be able to score more than three runs. The Red Sox bullpen is not good whatsoever. You should be able to score more than three runs. You didn't score one run off their bullpen. Not one. That is awful. And of course, it's got to be the guys that the Yankees traded away with Whitlock and Ottavino. It's got to be those guys, right? Just Red Sox are just rubbing it in the Yankees' face right now because that's what it's like being a Yankee fan. It's not easy. It's not as easy as it looks. I know, you know, people are going to call me spoiled. People are going to call Yankee fans spoiled for complaining about how they play. But the Yankees are just an unbelievably frustrating team to watch. They're without a doubt the most frustrating team in baseball. They're a team that's projected to win the World Series every year, or at least make the World Series, and they just always let us down year after year. They've done this to us every season. They bring you in, and then they disappoint you. You know, the Yankees had an opportunity to come back in the ninth inning off Matt Barnes, who's a damn good reliever, and they didn't. You know, Clint Frazier worked an 8-pitch at bat just to strike out, because that's what they do. They work long at bats just to strike out, and then DJ LeMahieu, doing typical DJ LeMahieu things, grounding out. And that ended the game on the double play as the Yankees lost 5-3. My recap for tonight's game, Domingo Germán really struggled. He wasn't as bad as his last start, but still really struggled. Bullpen did a good job, but the offense just was not good enough. Phil Nevin is a horrible third base coach. I don't know why you're sending Gio Urshela, a guy who didn't even play the past two games because he hurt himself. And he's a guy that does not run well to begin with. And he's also dealing with a leg injury. So I don't know why you're sending Urshela with no outs. And you could have had first and third, no one out. Instead, now you have a man on first base with one out. It completely changed the momentum of the game. And I think that was the reason why the Yankees lost. If that didn't happen, if they would have held him, the Yankees would have been tied. Or at least losing 5-4, and they would have had a chance to come back in the ninth. But just the offense did not do a good job. Phil Nevin is a horrible third base coach, and Domingo Germán just didn't pitch well. So that's my recap for tonight's game. So good win yesterday, winning the series against the lowly Royals, but we have not been able to beat the Red Sox this year. We have not beaten them once yet. Luckily, we have Monty on the mound tomorrow, who's been good as of late, going up against Nathan Eovaldi. Nathan Eovaldi pitched well against the Yankees his last outing, but it's Fenway Park. Anything can happen. Then game three, Gerrit Cole's on the mound. So if the Yankees can find a way to win tomorrow, they can win the series on Sunday, but I'm not confident that they will. They're now four games back behind the Red Sox and 4.5 behind the Rays. Being a Yankee fan is it's pretty miserable. This fan base has been tortured for years with unbelievably bad baseball, bad base running, bad coaching decisions, and just mediocrity. We have been mediocre the past 2 years. I don't know what our record is overall, but we have been a slightly over 500 team the past 2 years. So It's just pretty ridiculous how the Yankees had first and second, no one out in the ninth, and didn't score. They also had first and second, one out in, like, the fourth inning, and Gleyber Torres grounded into a double play. The Yankees had a chance to take the lead, and they didn't. You know, those opportunities are going to come back to bite you when you don't, you know, convert, and the Yankees didn't. They did not hit with men on base tonight, and they could not touch the Red Sox bullpen. For some odd reason, they could not touch the Red Sox pitchers tonight. They couldn't. Really outside of that second inning, they did not score a run after that, so offense was bad, and Germán didn't pitch well, but just a very tough loss tonight for the Yankees. I was very angry after when this game ended. I was so pissed off LeMahieu didn't get a hit there. I mean, DJ LeMahieu's been god-awful all year. You'd expect him to kind of clutch up a little bit, and he didn't. He grounded into a double play like he always does. That's why he's called DJ the ground out, because that's what he does. He grounds out. Just a unbelievably frustrating team. Unbelievable. A game they could have won, easily could have won. They haven't beaten the Red Sox yet this year. and I'm not happy about it. So that's going to do it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'm sorry I sound like a broken record right now, but this team is really killing me. They're giving me agita right now. I sound like Frank Fleming right now. They really do. This team really does give me agita. They do. They're really, really, really frustrating. One night they look great, next night they look awful. I know that they've lost the opener the past two series and they've came back to win the next two, but with Eovaldi on the mound, he's a guy that we never really have success against. I'm not confident that we'll win tomorrow, but hey, you never know. So that is going to do it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. What are your thoughts on Domingo Germán's performance? What are your thoughts on DJ LeMahieu's garbage game today? What are your thoughts on the offense, and what are your thoughts on this team overall? I'd love to know your thoughts on that down in the comments below. So that is going to do it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Peace, and go Yankees.